Good morning, and welcome to this time and place of worship, of lifting up a psalm, a prayer, and some of our favorite hymns to sing along, to listen to. Next week is going to be our last Lauds service for a little while. Take a little bit of a break for the summer, so if you have a favorite hymn, be sure to let us know by say Wednesday evening, and we'll try and include as many of those in a final Lauds service before the summer hits. And so let us take a moment and center ourselves in a moment of prayer. Loving God, we give thanks for this time together, this time and the technology that allows us to gather together even while we are still not gathering in person. May this time be a time of uplifting song and scripture and holding our world and ourselves in prayer. Amen.
We are marching in the light of God. 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 We are marching, we are marching, marching. We are marching in the light of God. We are marching, marching, we are marching. Humba kukan yen quen kos, see a humba kukan yen quen kos. See a humba kukan yen quen kos, see a humba kukan yen quen kos. See a humba, humba, see a humba, humba, see a humba kukan yen quen kos. See a humba, humba, kia humba, humba, see a humba kukan yen quen kos. We are marching in the light of God. 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 We are marching, marching, we are marching, marching, we are marching in the light of God. We are marching, marching, we are marching. Marching in the light of God.
selections from Psalm 86 would be part of the lectionary readings for this coming Sunday. We won't be using a psalm on Sunday, but we lift up some of those verses now. Psalm 86 is a psalm of petition. There are elements of lament and really petition for help at a time of distress. The Psalms, as a collection of works, embody so much human emotion. They run the full gamut in various psalms. Many of the psalms we've been using in our Lauds services have been psalms of praise and thanksgiving. This one includes that element of petition for help. And so elements of Psalm 86. Incline your ear, O Lord, and answer me, for I am poor and needy. Preserve my life, for I am devoted to you. Save your servant who trusts in you. You are my God. Be gracious to me, O Lord, for to you do I cry all day long. Gladden the soul of your servant, for to you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. For you, O Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in steadfast love to all who call on you. Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer. Listen to my cry of supplication. In the day of my trouble, I call on you, for you will answer me. There is none like you among the gods, O Lord, nor are there any works like yours. All the nations you have made shall come and bow down before you, O Lord, and shall glorify your name. For you are great and do wondrous things. You alone are God. Turn to me and be gracious to me. Give your strength to your servant. Save the child of your servant girl. Show me a sign of your favor so that those who hate me may see it and be put to shame. Because you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me. Amen.
That God has planned where love shines through. When Moses heard the call of God, he said, Lord, don't send me. But God told Moses, you're the one to set my people free. Walk with me, I will walk with you, and build the land that God has planned where love shines through. Now Peter was a most unlikely man to lead the flock, but Jesus knew his holiness, and he became the rock. Walk with me, I will walk with you, and build the land that God has planned where love shines through. Young Mary Magdalene was sure her life could be much more, but by her faith she dared to let God's love unlock the door. Walk with me, I will walk with you, and build the land that God has planned where love shines through. And when you share your faith with me and work for life anew, witness of your faithfulness calls me to walk with you. Walk with me, I will walk with you, and build the land that God has planned where love shines through.
Well, the song that Kirk and I are about to sing for you. I'm going to sing it, and Kirk's going to join me. It's called Peace in the Valley, and Peace in the Valley has been requested by Lansing, and he obviously has heard it from a long time ago, because it was actually recorded first in 1950, and it's been recorded by many people, and I've heard a few different versions of this, and none of them appear to be the same, but the most famous version was by Elvis Presley. And Elvis actually performed it on the Ed Sullivan Show on January 6, 1957, and it was before an audience estimated at 54.6 million people, which is obviously a lot of people for that time, even now. So Elvis closed that Ed Sullivan show by dedicating the song to the 250,000 refugees fleeing Hungary after the 24th and 31st of October 1956 double invasion of that country by the Soviet Union. And because he also requested that immediate and be sent to lessen their plight, the appeal in turn yielded contributions amounting to over $6 million US, which would be about $49.5 million in today's currency. So, as I said, a lot of different people have done this song, and there are so many different interpretations of it. I'm going to try and keep as close to the actual written music as possible, but you forgive me, Lance, if I don't do it exactly the way you've envisioned it.
I am tired and weary, but I must toil on till the Lord comes to call me away. Well, the morning's so bright, and the lamb is the night, and the night is as fair as the day. There'll be peace in the valley for me someday. There'll be peace in the valley for me, I pray. No more sorrow and sadness or troubles will be. There'll be peace in the valley for me. There the flowers will be blooming, the grass will be green, and the skies will be clear and serene. The sun ever shines, giving one endless beam, and the clouds there will ever be seen. There'll be peace in the valley for me someday. There'll be peace in the valley for me, I pray. No more sorrow and sadness or troubles will be. There'll be peace in the valley for me. Where the bear will be gentle, the wolves will be tame, and the lion shall lay down by the lamb. And the beasts from the wild shall be led by a child. I'll be changed from the creature I am. There'll be peace in the valley for me someday. There'll be peace in the valley before me. I pray no more sorrow and sadness or troubles will be. There'll be peace in the valley for me.
And so let us pray. Loving God, we give thanks for many blessings of life, for family and friends, for neighbors and loved ones, people that were starting to move towards being able to see in ways that feel more normal and more connected. We give thanks for the ability we've had to make creative use of technology in bringing us together even while apart. Loving God, I lift up and celebrate something that I've been a part of this week through the musical community, helping to help run the string section of the Brandt Music Festival, which took a virtual twist this year, seeing classes being run by Zoom, and what a joy it's been to see children still being able to play, to work towards a musical goal, and then to come together and celebrate with their friends in a music festival. And the parents and the teachers who've supported and have made that possible. We lift up the students and the teachers in our midst who are coming to a time or have come to a time of transition as we move towards summer. We lift up the many blessings and of life and all of the ways that we celebrate life together in birthdays and anniversaries. And so while we recognize that there are many things for which we give thanks, we recognize that we come to worship with worries and concerns, and that each of us holds concerns deep in our hearts. And so we lift up those we know who are ill, who are grieving, who feel alone. We know that there are still people who are feeling very isolated at this time. And so we pray that we might not forget, just because some things are moving towards a sense of normalcy, that there are still those in our midst who are feeling very alone. And so we lift up them. We lift up our world. We pray that we might find ways of living more justly so that each of us, all people, might flourish regardless of race or skin color, who one loves, how one dresses, all of the isms that bring brokenness to relationship. And we lift up a prayer for our world that we might continue to find ways of using resources in ways that all of our world might flourish as we move into the future. And so we lift up the prayers of our hearts, those we voiced aloud and those we carry too deep for words, trusting in your presence with us always, as a mother brooding over us, and as our Father who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Deep in our hearts, there is a common vision. Deep in our hearts, there is a common song. Deep in our hearts, there is a common story, telling creation that we are one. Deep in our hearts, there is a common purpose. Deep in our hearts, there is a common goal. Deep in our hearts, there is a sin. a common longing deep in our hearts. There is a common theme deep in our hearts. There is a common current flowing in freedom like a stream. Deep in our hearts, there is a common vision. Deep in our hearts, there is a common song. Deep in our hearts, there is a common story telling creation that we are one.
And so as we go forth from this space, as we go forth into our day, may we go with the grace and peace of God, which surpasses all our understanding, keeping watch over our hearts and minds now and always. May we go in peace, love, and in hope. Amen.